Hello friends, welcome back to Civil Engineering Mastery. In this video, let's learn about load bearing structure and its foundation details. So let me explain you what is load bearing structure and what is the load transfer mechanism and what are all the limitations it has and what are all the materials used. Along with that, let me explain how to read the foundation details that includes excavation plan and cross-section details. So let's start now. So first let's see what is load bearing structure. It is also called wall bearing structure. As we all know that if we are going to construct a building, we are familiar with column, beam and slab, right? So that is called frame structure, and this one is called load bearing structure. That means like here we are transferring the load, slab load and other floor load through walls. Here we are not using any column and beam. So you should know the difference between frame structure and the load bearing structure. In frame structure we use beam and column, and in load bearing structure we use walls to transfer the load. It has to transfer the load safely to the foundation. The main objective of this load bearing structure is it has to transfer the load safely to the foundation. So what are all the structural elements does the load bearing structure has? Slab, walls and footing. So in this image itself you can see the slab load is directly transferred to walls, and the walls are transferring the load to the foundation of the load bearing structure. One is the load transfer mechanism for load bearing structure. In load bearing structure, the load transfer from slab to walls and then walls to foundation and foundation to the soil. So this is the load transfer mechanism of load bearing structure. Whereas in a frame structure, the slab load will transfer to beams and then beam load will transfer to columns and column load will transfer to the footing and then it goes to soil. So this is the difference in load transfer mechanism between load bearing structure and the frame structure. Let's see what are all the materials used in load bearing structure. We use sidestone masonry, random rubble masonry, bricks, solid blocks, cement mortar and lime mortar. So apart from this, many materials we use. So these are all the major materials we use in load bearing structure. Next, let's see what are all the limitations of load bearing structure. When compared to frame structure, it has many limitations. Long walls cannot be constructed at a stretch, whereas in frame structure we can construct long walls at a stretch. Since we have columns and beams, we can construct a long walls at a stretch in frame structure. When the height increases, the thickness of walls also get increases, because walls are the major load bearing element in the load bearing structure. It does not resist lateral forces. It require more wall thickness. So what happens when we use more wall thickness, you know, the spaces and all, the room spaces and all will get reduced. And whereas in frame structure, since we are using columns, the loads are transferred to beams and columns, so we don't require more wall thickness, so that gives more space. It can be constructed only up to 2 to 3 stories, whereas in frame structure we can go up to multi stories. In load bearing structure we can construct only 2 to 3 stories. For load bearing structure, the soil type should be hard soil. We cannot construct load bearing structure on clay soil. It requires more labor and it is time consuming, because now it load bearing structure depends on labor. Manual work is more in this load bearing structure, so it is more time consuming. It is not flexible when compared to frame structural system, because in frame structure we can alter the room sizes and spaces whenever we require, because walls are not carrying any loads. So here in load bearing structure, once it is decided, means like the loads are transferring through walls, so we cannot alter any walls after designing. So these are all the limitations of load bearing structure. It has few advantages as well. So it is more durable and it has more fire resistance, and there is no requirement of bar bending. Like if we are doing with a frame structure, we need to procure steel and we have to do the bar bending work and all. So that and all, it is not need in load bearing structure, and it is aesthetically attractive, and the materials and tools and materials are required for this load bearing structure are very simple. Now let me show you how do we read the foundation details for load bearing structure. So this is the architectural plan of the load bearing structure. Next, let's see the excavation plan. So in the excavation plan, we have all the grid lines which is similar to the frame structure, and instead of columns and footings, we have the walls here. So this yellow color line indicates the wall, and we have 8 inch thick wall, and this dotted line indicates the excavation line. So we have the width of excavation is 3 feet 4 inches, and we took many sections to know the cross section details, so that I'll explain you. Whereas in frame structure, we have columns and footing like this. I have already uploaded one video for how to read footing drawings. So I'll give the link in the description box. So if you want, you can go and check that. Next, let's see the cross section details. So if you cut the section here, what we will see, we'll see the excavation line, and then what are all the other things will come at this place. So this is section AA. So here we have 3 feet 4 inch width of PCC. So that is about the excavation line. And next we have 4 inch thick RCC. And next we have size stone masonry, 30 inch width, that is 2 feet 6 inch width of size stone masonry. And again we have the second course, size stone masonry width of 18 inches. Okay, so here these levels are very important. So at plinth level, below plinth we have 1 feet 6 inches, and below NGL represents the natural ground level, that is 00 level. So below that we have to go for 3 feet or up to hard strata. This foundation depth varies according to the soil condition, and after this 2 course of masonry, we are going to construct a 8 inch thick wall. So this is the foundation details for this 8 inch thick wall. So this is load bearing wall. So whatever the slab load is coming from the top roof level, so that load will transfer to this 8 inch thick wall, and this 8 inch thick wall will transfer the load to this foundation. So this is the foundation details for load bearing structure. PCC also we are providing 4 inch thick. Here the PCC ratio is 1:2:4. Usually we provide 1:4:8. So here why we are providing 1:4 is like the soil below the foundation is also hard soil, and the load coming from the top is also more. So in between we have to provide little bit strong material. So that is why we are providing 1:4, because 1:4:8 is little weak when compared to 1:4:1:4. So that is why between hard soil and the load coming from the top, so we have to provide some strong base to safely transfer the load to the foundation. So that is why here we are providing PCC ratio is 1:2:4. So let's see the detail A for 4 inch thick RCC. So this is the detail A, 4 inch thick RCC. So Y8 at 18 center to center, and even distribution bars we are providing Y8 at 18 center to center. So friends, this is how you have to read the excavation drawing or foundation drawing for load bearing structure. If you all like this video, please do comment in the comment box, and don't forget to subscribe this channel for more videos. And friends, join button has been enabled in our channel. So if you wanted to take membership, you can take to get some extra benefits. Thank you for watching.